Hey guys, well today in this video I'm going to work on installing this cable tray, and we're going to put it for our x-axis wiring and cabling. And this is what I have. And so what I planned on doing was install it like so. And then the cables will run out of here and around back and then come out the front like so. We'll just run along and keep it nice and up and out of the way. And as the Z-axis moves, so will the cable tray, and it'll keep everything nice and tight. We'll see how this is going to work out, because this may get filled with chips and stuff, but I'm thinking it being in the back and not the front, it should be okay. But I got this nice cableway for my cables to run through, but the problem is I didn't order it quite big enough. I wasn't sure what I would need, and it's only 20 millimeters thick, and it needs to be a little bit thicker because my aviation plugs won't quite fit through there. So you need something that's at least probably say 24 millimeters. And the width on this is 27, so I would say something a little bit wider, maybe 32, somewhere around 24 thick, 32 wide should be just fine. But I didn't let that stop me, since I already have this. The ones that we use at work, I can't remember the brand name of them, but they have these little piece right here, folds and clips. So I thought when I ordered this, but this stuff came from China. When I ordered this, I thought that's the type this was, but it wasn't. But luckily, I found a solution. And what I did was, I just separate the links and then take a pair of channel locks, and I'm gonna squeeze it and slide. I can get it bent to bend just enough to slide these through, and it bounces. Give it a little squeeze on the side, it bounces right back into shape. Just slide it down, make my connection, they just kind of pop together, and I'll just rebuild it like that. So I'm going to go ahead and finish doing the other 50 links, and then we'll get back with you. Okay, well, about an hour later, and I finally got the cable tray all put together. And let me show you what I did. Pretty simple to mount it. Basically, I just stuck a couple screws in here at the bottom, and that secured the back end. And then underneath, this channel's flat right here. So had I had very good pre-planning, I could have bored and tapped a couple of holes under there, but rather than try to disassemble this whole thing just to screw that on, I decided just to go with some 3M double-sided sticky tape, and I put about a 3-inch strip under there, and hopefully that'll secure it. And if I can get a year's worth of use out of that, then I'll be happy, and it's easily replaced. So, and you can see that how the cable tray works. Keeps my wires, any kind of binding or pinching. And it keeps it nice and neat, and hopefully it being in the rear, it'll stay out of the path of any kind of mess. we'll see how that goes. So now I have my x-axis home switch, and I'm not sure how I'm going to really mount it. I've seen people mount them somewhere like this, but then I lose all this travel. You really want it to hit, you know, way back here so that you pick up all the travel you need. Now, with my X mount, I actually have this will actually go back another half inch, but the most I can turn on this 10 inch lathe is 5 inches. So I'm already right there's about 5 inches from the center line, so I'm not really going to need to go back much further than that. So even though I have an extra half inch of travel, I don't really need it. And for the most part, most of the stuff I'm going to be turning is way smaller than that, probably, you know, inch or two in diameter. So I could mount it up here so that it hits the back of this, but then I'm really only going to get about if I mount it somewhere like this, then I'm going to lose about 2 1/4 inches of travel, and I'll be able to turn a 6-inch diameter, which really would be enough for most everything I'm going to turn. But I'm still kicking this around. I may just fabricate a bracket and have it come back to at least here. And that'll give me an 8-inch diameter. So I'm pretty good with that. So I'm going to have to try to figure up some mounts. So let me do that and we'll get this mounted. So what I thought I'd do here is I just took a scrap piece here, and I'm just going to use the two holes that I already have here, and I'm just going to mount a bracket like so, and then mount my switch to the bracket in this fashion. I could even put it on the inside, I guess, but I'll probably put the switch I guess I will put it on the inside, and then I'll just mount the switch here like so. And then when the X comes back, it'll trip it. That'll give me way more travel on the X than I need. So I think that'll be good. So I'm just gonna machine this piece of scrap down and bore some holes in it so it'll fit. The Z axis is pretty straightforward, I believe. Probably just do some kind of mount it maybe right here, and it can just hit if I mount it right here. Then it can just hit up against this. So next we're going to work on getting some brackets, and let me do that and we'll come back and take a look at that. All right, well, you can see that we have our home switches connected and wired in. I had to make this little bracket. This is just some 1/4-inch bar that I made for the x-axis. And I had to kind of relieve it here just a little bit so that this plate for the adjustment of the belt can go up and down and it clears it. And there is a little play right here, so it's not rubbing this. And the plate's probably not going to come up anymore. It's only going to go down if the belt stretches, so I'm not too worried about that. It's secure. I have just thought about maybe putting some slots right here in this bracket so that I can move this back a little bit more. But the way it is right now, in the home position, from the end of the tool bit to the center of the stock is 4 inches, so I can get an 8-inch radius. I don't think I'm going to be turning anything 8 inches diameter, so if that ever comes about, then I can make some changes. Plus, I'm going to be, I've ordered a piece of steel stock to get rid of this compound rest. It's just going to be a spacer to hold my SARS, SARS quick change tool post. So when we get that mounted, it's going to change anyways. So right now, even though I have 18 1/4 inches of travel on my Z and 11 inches of travel on my X, really, I don't need that. I don't know that I'll ever move the bit in further than center line. And I can only go, the maximum I need to come backwards is 5 inches, because this is only a 10-inch lathe. So I think I'm good here, and we'll see how this is going to work out. The limit switch for the Z-axis, I just used some 3M double-sided sticky tape and stuck it on there. It's really secure. This little spring is very light, so the switch doesn't move at all when it's tripped. And I did that for a couple of reasons. I'm not sure that's the permanent position that I want to put the switch in. I'm thinking I may move it up here halfway somewhere. That way, when I'm referencing, it doesn't have to go all the way back to here to reference home. Most of my turning is probably going to be within 12 inches, so it'll just kind of speed things up. So after I got the home switches in, now what I want to do is I really want to fine-tune my homing and limits. So you go up to configuration, homing and limits, and my soft maximum is of course zero, because I'm going to be moving both axes in a negative direction. And for my soft minimum, we need to set the Z. Let's actually see how far we need to set the Z. I'm looking at machine coordinates right now, and let's just move Z all the way up. Okay, that's 17 1/4. I can probably go another 1/4 inch, but as you can see, my tool's already really close to the chuck, so I don't really want to go any closer to that. And I do have an extra 1/4 inch here if I need, if I'm doing some other kind of turning and I have a face plate on here or something, then I can make some adjustments. Now 17 1/4, so go up to configuration, homing and limits, and I have my Z set in a negative direction for my minimum at 17 1/4. If you have 17 1/4, negative 17 1/4 here for the maximum, because you're thinking that that's the maximum distance you want it to travel, remember that this is a negative number. So you want the positive number on the max and the negative number on the minimum. If you have them reversed, then you won't be able to set your home, in auto here, you won't be able to set your soft limits. You won't be able to turn that on if you have them the other way around. Let me show you. So if I change this to zero, and I change this to negative 17.25, You see it says machine is out of limits for soft limit activation. So you have to just remember that your maximum is always going to be a positive number, and zero being our positive number, and negative 17.25 will be our negative. And for our for my x-axis, if I take and move it to the home, if I set the home, that's on my home switch, and if I look and measure, I can get my tape measure in here. Let me move this so I can get. That's right about on my center line. I apologize for the lighting in here. It's a rainy day out. You can see I have about 4 inches. And so that'll give me an 8-inch radius. But I probably not going to turn anything on a regular basis more than a couple inches, 3 inches in diameter. So now the maximum. How far do I need to bring my tool bit in? Well, when I get my quick change set up in my spacer block, I'll know more accurately. But as you can see, I'm already way past the center line, so I don't think that I'll need to go much more than that. So I'm going to set my homing and limits to 4.5 for the X, and again, the negative 4.5 is your minimum, and the maximum is the positive number. My speed for my homing, if you leave this on 1, which is default, you can see what happens and how slow it is. Homing. That will take you all day. So make sure that you do change that, because the default is, make sure you change that. The default is 1%. You can go 10%. I found that a happy place speed for this is about 25%. So for me, depends on what your velocity set out for your motors. So I've got mine set up 25%. And that's good speed. Now, I'm in machine coordinates, and you can see that Z is at, X is at 0 because we just hit home, and then my Z is at 14, almost 15 inches, negative 15 inches. My parts, they're still at 0. I haven't set any of those. Now, this home X button just takes. This home X button takes X to home. That's what this button does. The home all button will take both axes to home. I don't believe it references them, but it does take them to the home switch. This zero world X, I'm not real sure how, this is pretty, I looked in the manual last night, and it's pretty vague on what that actually does, and so I'm not really sure how that affects your overall work when you're using it, but so I'm not sure. If anybody's got any clarification on this zero world, please feel free to comment and let me know on that. And I'm still kind of learning this whole screen setup because it's a lot different than the mill. There's a lot of things that are similar, but in a lot of ways it's different. So, but anyways, that pretty much takes care of this video with our software setup for our home switches, and I think they turned out really well. That's definitely very secure. It's away from a lot of the splash, so I'm hoping that this is a good spot for it. I know the Z should be safe way back there. I got a couple of tools in here in the four-way tool post, and I kind of played around with it just a little bit, and I'll maybe generate a little G code and just run a part with this four-way tool post. I've got a block. I need a 2-inch high and a four and almost 5-inch wide block of steel for my spacer for my quick change tool post. So when that gets in, I'll be working on that. We still got to get our coolant done. As you can see, the cable tray works really nice. So I'm really happy with that. It's going to keep the cables out of the way, keep them from binding. So that's going to be really good. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So I appreciate you watching the videos. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel. Have a great day.